in Cebu this year, this season, or in other parts of Manila or Philippines?
So this season, again, the home opener or the season opener is tomorrow, October 2nd at SML Asia Arena with a doubleheader. The next game in the Philippines will be at Phil Sports Arena on November 13th, also a doubleheader. Then on January 15th and January 22nd, there'll be single games, and also at the Philippine Sports Arena. So as of right now, no other games scheduled for Cebu or any other areas, but the possibility of a Final Four, like similar to what we did last season, is still up in the air.
Yeah, I was just add to that. We're very pleased to be actually finishing the season last year in Cebu here in the Philippines, and then to be starting the season this time here in Manila. We're not yet announcing the location for our Final Four. We'll do that in the near future, but we're very pleased to be having these six games in the Philippines this time.
What makes season two different from season one? Will there be, what's the changes now in season two?
Sorry, what's the difference?
Yeah, do you have any improvement that you make to the for the season two?
So I mean, right away from the structure going from 8 teams to now 10 teams, it added in the extra 2 teams, one from Hong Kong, one from Macau. It's adding an extra, you know, layer of more games for us and more ability for us to bring the basketball, our high quality of basketball, to the fans in those territories. So it's, you know, increase the competition. So that's the biggest difference from our first season to our second.
You increase the competition, you also increase the incentives?
The incentives will still be the same. As some of you may know, last season, Chiba Jets from the Japanese B League won the championship for the season, and they were awarded a $1 million cash prize. This season will be the same, so all teams will be gunning for the same cash prize.
Okay, good morning, Gab Perez, coming from Sports Corner PH. I missed the first part of this conversation, pero can we tell our followers what do we expect on the opening day of the EASL this coming tomorrow? What will be the first game, and of course, an expectation that we will have a solid home crowd for this competition? First question.
Sure. The first part, what do we expect? I think we're going to expect two great games between four championship ball clubs. As I mentioned earlier, game one, the tip-off will be at 6:10 p.m. That will be between the San Miguel Beermen taking on the Korean Basketball League's Suwon KT Sonic Boom. And the second game will feature the Morocco Bolts taking on the Macau Black Bears.
And of course, with the presence of our PBA Ball Club, San Miguel de los Beermen and the Morocco Bolts, we expect that, of course, the EASL will have a great numbers of popularity, whether it's in the viewership, through streaming, or the live coverages, and even at our venues, all those who wanted to watch those games, either home or away.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's a great opportunity for our fans to experience the best basketball clubs in Asia competing, but more importantly, even for viewers all around the world, as Adam was mentioning, you know, we have our broadcast partners that are showing the game live. But you know, we're thankful for Signal TV to be back with us through One Sports Plus, as well as Pilipinas Live. So I think the fans will have the opportunity to catch the games not only in person, but in the comforts of their own homes or on their cell phones.
Okay, last question. Do you think that the Philippines would be a great powerhouse in Philippine basketball in the coming years? And are we expect to expand the pool of teams that the EASL will be competing? Thank you and good morning.
Absolutely. You know, I think here the PBA being the second oldest professional league in the world, second to the NBA. The popularity of the game of basketball here in the Philippines is second to none. So I feel that our teams, our PBA teams, will be competing for, you know, many, many years here in the EASL. And I feel that hopefully, I guess I'm, you know, wearing the Philippine hat, I would like to see a PBA team win an ESL championship very, very soon.
But I would say, look, we welcome you to come join us tomorrow night in the SM Mall of Asia Arena, as well as, you know, watch it on Signal, the broadcast. But you'll come, you'll see the place where our champions clash. These are the best of the best from the leagues around this region in East Asia. And we are certainly expecting that in the seasons to come, they'll see some additional teams coming into our league. We are always talking with other leagues around this region, even in Southeast Asia, about the possibility of having them come in to join our league. Could be even more teams from North Asia, from China, Mongolia. So stay tuned. We are always talking with like-minded basketball fans and teams and leagues to build the best possible Champions League of Asia.
Thank you.
Any special show for any special event for as part of the opening and also for the fans?
Yeah, absolutely. Tomorrow, you know, we invite all the fans to be there. It's going to be one big party, you know, on and off the court. We have, you know, a lot of music with, you know, the top DJs, not only in the Philippines but around the region, will be performing. We have world class hip hop dance teams performing as well. And some of your favorite celebrities sitting courtside with us. So ESL, you know, not only we have the champions clashing, but we also have our friends from all over entertainment here flying in for tomorrow's game.
It's going to be a basketball party tomorrow, huh?
Absolutely.
Yes. Questions, gentlemen? Okay, Mr. President.
You're welcoming two expansion teams for the season, and you mentioned about the possibility of teams from North Asia. How about the possibility of Australia or New Zealand being invited, expanding over to the Oceania region, considering those teams are also playing in the PBA Asia?
Yeah, I'll start off first, and then Ben, you can chime in. But look, I think, you know, when we have a league like we have with the champions of Asia playing each other, it attracts a lot of attention. So we have a lot of interest from different leagues around the region, you know, close by and as well as further away, about trying to participate in this league. We enjoy that. We like that. We welcome it. You know, we want to be able to have the best teams playing against the best teams all across the world. So we need to work on the logistics of how we would make that happen. So there are a lot of conversations going on about how to best structure something like that. So right now, we were so pleased to be able to go from our first season with 8 teams to the second season with 10 teams, adding in 2 more territories. So please stay tuned. We'll try to make announcements as soon as we can, but we're always having conversations with other leagues about having more teams join.
To just add to that, as some of you may remember, the head coach of the Bay Area Dragons, Coach Brian Gorigin, who is a long time, the winningest coach in Australia, coached Australian national team, the Boomers as well. He's one of our ESL ambassadors. He's back in Australia coaching the Sydney Kings. He's going to always be there and connecting us with that side of the world. When it comes to basketball, and we keep an open conversation with them about developing the game. So the possibility of having teams outside of East Asia for right now, maybe down the road, but for right now the focus is within the region.
Yes. Questions, gentlemen? Okay, yeah. Ivan, dito ka na lang. Kasi, please. Okay, Ivan Sui.
Good morning, gentlemen. Ivan Swing from the I want to ask you, how excited are you for the opening clip of knowing that you guys will start